Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Who Called in the Fleet. This is episode 2 of the new series. And as always, I am D, and we're going to go back to fighting for the Gothic sector. Now, a couple of things before we get going. First off, a correction. I said last time that this is set during the 13th Black Crusade. I was wrong. The Gothic War, which is what Battlefleet Gothic is all about, is actually the 12th Black Crusade. And that is... I was still right about Abaddon trying to take control of the Blackstone fortresses. Also, I found out their level of power. Two of them can destroy a planet when you combine their firepower. Three of them can set a star to go Nova. So that's how strong the Blackstone fortresses actually are. Now, there were some updates since the last episode. Also, I did play a little bit behind the scenes, so off camera. The first big change you'll notice: The orc pirates are now in, so yeah, I would try and do the orc voice, but frankly, I'm not that good at sounding Cockney. So, I did try them out. They're okay. I didn't win by any stretch. The orc's basic strategy is that what you want to do is aim your ships straight at them, and just ram everybody with anything, pretty much. Their ships are pretty strong. They take a long time to take down. The problem is their best weapons are on the front, and your basic strategy is ramming everything. So, yeah, the orcs, they're fun, but they're not exactly all that sane. I'm gonna stick with chaos. Now, like I said, I did play behind the scenes a little bit, so I'm up to level 4 now with my Chaos Admiral, who had a name. Oh, wait, no, there's the name. We've actually got a couple of new additions. First off, actually, there's some chaos ships for you. First off, we now have two cruisers. We still have the Fury. We lost the Scion of Blood, or it was renamed, I think, into the Fury of Pain. We also have the Worshipper of Submission. Now, normally I would rename this, but decided, you know what, screw it. I'm just gonna let it stay on. That is a murder class. We still have the Slaughter class for the Fury of Pain. We still have our 4 light cruisers. We've also gained the ability to put an upgrade on our escort ships. I don't have the renown I need to do that, but we can work on that. Alright. Back to fighting. Now, most of the time, okay, we're doing a 300-point breakthrough mission where I am the defender. I hate these missions. Let's take the Flame of... Do we want... Yeah, let's take the Flame of Despair. Lance battery... 2 lance batteries, 2 heavy macro turrets. That'll work. And then we're gonna spend... There we go, and we have an idolater. Actually, let's try something a little different. Next, let's stick with my original plan, because that gives us also a plasma bomb. Do I have anybody with a stasis bomb? No. Actually, yeah, I do, but it's the worshiper. Alright, here we go. We've got 3 ships. We have an Idolater Raider down there to the bottom. We have the Fury of Pain leading the charge. We have the stations that we had to defend. The stations do still have, they still have that heavy macro turret that you can see on top of them. Okay, I forget, we're facing Orks. Great. Actually, that's not terrible, because Orks are actually pretty slow ships. Their ships are slow, they're not very... they don't change direction very well. They do have heavy, heavy front guns, though, so I gotta watch out for that. Luckily, most Chaos ships are really, really good at side gunning. Unfortunately, that does mean my Infidel here is gonna probably be screwed over, but it's a Raider. What do I care? Be fully prepared to sacrifice Also, that's another thing that changed. The slaughter cruiser that we got in the last episode got upgraded with a missile pod turret. I didn't put it there. Somebody else did. Also, I mentioned that I didn't know both companies behind this. The developer of this is Tyndallus Interactive. They're doing well with this so far. And the publisher is Focus Home Interactive. Pretty good company. I like what Focus has done. Oh wow, they're just going hard on this already. I'm just gonna let them run.
Come on, me!
I'm just gonna let them run out of fuel while I move in to shoot them. Because orc ships are they're full ahead. It lasts it can go faster than mine. So the red ones do go faster. That's an orc thing. But it goes in fits and starts. So it'll sometimes be faster, sometimes it'll be slower. Other time, the problem is it lasts about half as long. Range on that is 9,000. Range on that is 15,000. So we're gonna cut you down to 9,000.
Ready eternally.
Oh shit! Get out of the. Well, he's dead.
We'll follow your command for now.
Oh, that was a shield destroyer bomb. That was it.
Your orders. We have sighted an enemy ship.
Micro warp jump.
Break them in mind and body.
Oh crap! They've activated the log. That is one of the orc special abilities they can get. Basically, I'm also not going to be able to really do any assault actions. Luckily, the orc ships are not very maneuverable.
Adjusting rotation.
I need to turn, and then fire torpedoes.
Just show us something.
I might have still missed.
Break them in mind and body.
Unfortunately, my ship.
Come on, me.
Unfortunately, the Flame of Despair lost its engines. So aim for that.
For the Dark Gods.
Because orc weapons like it. Yeah, you see, orcs are very good at ramming things. And in fact, they're both gonna go for that. Okay, the shields were down.
Ready eternally.
They're probably gonna win this, because I've never had to deal with the orcs before.
Your orders!
Also, to be fair, the reason I'm not
unstoppable.
Shit. Pop the shields.
Come on, me. Engines hot. Come on, me. Just show us something to kill.
Good lightning strike worked that time.
Chaos defense platform destroyed.
Okay, I'm gonna lose the defense platforms, but at this rate.
For the Dark Gods!
Hopefully if I just kill one of them, I can win.
Your orders!
The problem is they got a terror cruiser over there. And so far, it's living up to its name of the Never Defeated Ripper.
Just show us something to kill!
Okay, I'm not gonna.
We've come for your souls!
Both of you turn onto there.
For the Dark Gods!
Fire the plasma bomb.
Your orders.
That's one dead greenskin ship.
Come on, me!
Fire the lightning strike. Good. They might still destroy this defense platform, but at this
rate.
Ready
eternally.
You know what? Actually, let's disable their engines.
Let the galaxy burn! Just show us something to kill!
Reload.
Okay. Reloading ordnance!
Start ordering all of my ships to reload.
We come for your souls!
Good, they failed on the boarding, because that is actually the one thing the orcs are really good at. Oop, they didn't fail it entirely.
Just show us something to kill! Chaos defense platform destroyed!
Alright, they have to... This thing has to escape now, so...
For the Dark Gods! Tear them apart! Command me! We come for your souls!
Also, orc ships can't... As far as I remember, orc ships can't do high energy turns like I just did.
Let the galaxy burn! Break them in mind and body! Your orders!
And we get to a point where...
Command me!
Launch the plasma bomb.
Let the galaxy burn!
Is it gonna escape in time? No, it's not. That bomb is going off.
For the ruinous
Unfortunately,
powers.
it's gonna get into the cloud. We got it. I did not think I was gonna win that one. But the orcs, they're good on the attack. They're not very good on defense. I mean, I was defending at that point, so that's a little odd to say, but 150 renown for that, and a level up on both my ships. Okay, the Master Gunner is where he needs is maxed out. I don't need to worry about using demonic influence just yet because this is still my flagship for the most part. Cultists. And the Flame of Despair. Let's see, what kind of weapons do you have? Macro turret, lance batteries, Master Gunner. Alright, let's go for another one because, I mean, I could actually be sure. Can I have, do I have enough? No. Because it's 200 to upgrade my escort ships. An assassination mission versus the Imperium. Okay, I'm good with this. Let's bring the Fury of Injustice. And an iconoclast. And yes, I know chaos ships are excessively pointy, but that's not anything Tyndalos has done. That's how Games Workshop depicts all of their chaos stuff. It's basically you put spikes. Oh, and wait, I'm the defender. Crap. I thought I was the attacker. So I have to keep my admiral alive, I have to keep my flagship alive. And reach this point back here. Actually, you know what? I need to redeploy. Because you're at the one thing about this game mode is that if you're the defender, the admiral is always identified automatically.
We've come for your souls!
Do I have to? No, I don't have to reach anywhere. I just have to survive. All right, they've got looks like 5 ships so far.
Just show us something to kill.
Okay, good. I did. Plasma bomb. Actually, that looks like it's gonna hit 2 of them. Yep, it's gonna hit 2.
We have sighted an enemy ship. Command me!
Launch the bombers.
Your orders! Let the galaxy burn!
The That's an auger.
For the dark gods!
They've got three line ships.
We come for your souls!
Shit.
For the ruinous powers! Ready eternally. We're unstoppable!
We're boned.
Your orders!
Unfortunately, weakest armor is at the back of the ship.
We'll follow your command, for now!
They can still see my ship. Watch the bombers on that
thing. Tear them apart! Moving to those coordinates!
Oh, wait.
Cruising speed set! Ready eternally.
Well, I think I got one of their escorts, so that's something. At least I get some renown out of this.
Moving to those coordinates! For the dark gods! Just show us something to kill!
Right now, so I'm actually going to send you to group two so that I can actually...
Setting course!
Order you to go places that don't
tremble,
put you into
some
serious
danger. Comes.
And yeah, you can also queue up orders like I just did. What you do is you select your ship, tell it to do something, and then you hold shift and tell it to do something else.
Just show us something to kill!
Launching the bombers.
For the dark gods! Forward to the slaughter! For the dark gods!
Burn the engines as hot as I can.
Repair my ship or else!
As long as I need. What are you doing?
Cruising speed set! Ready eternally!
Drop the plasma right there.
Stop the rituals!
Trigger the warp jump.
Charging warp engines!
Okay, he's gonna make it out. That should count as a victory, I think. Because I just had to defend him until he could escape. Yep, that's a victory. I think I'll do one more, because that was a pretty short mission. I'm thinking of doing maybe three per episode on this. Alright, lost 8 renown to fleet upkeep, but we gained 4 bonus because I didn't use all 300 of my points. Destroyed 1 enemy ship, so I gained 11 for that, and I got 90 just for winning. Alright, let's go ahead and do one more after. Let's see what this. Let's see what we got this time. Because the game mode is just randomly assigned. Okay, a 500 point cruiser clash and I'm on the attack. Against Chaos. Alright, let's go. So we've got the Fury of Pain, the Worshipper of Submission, and let's bring... Let's bring the Fury of Injustice. And an infidel and 2 infidel raiders. So yes, we're gonna roll here with 5 ships. We've actually got the makings of a full-on fleet now. a good place to deploy. How about, dust cloud. Oh, that reminds me. I also found this button, advanced mode info. So now you can see that there's a dust cloud here. There's two, actually, you know what, let's not deploy there because that's directly into a big meteor, asteroid field. Why do I keep saying meteors? Right, let's go ahead and deploy here. And then we're gonna have two Outrider ships. There we go. Okay, so you cannot click and drag and move the screen. That's a little annoying.
Okay. Command me!
Oh good, they've got one ship just sitting out here
in on its own. Just show us something to kill! Tear them apart!
The whole fleet should be going, not just the
ready
front
eternally.
Lines. Okay, let's also knock you down to 9,000 range. You're already at 9,000 kids. That's where you're...
Your orders!
You're going to be facing the front. And you are going to be facing the front.
For the Dark Gods!
I think they might.
Ready,
okay, yeah, they've got at least five ships.
Slaughter them!
I think there's actually a difference between cruising speed and combat speed.
Ready, eternally.
To a small degree. Launching plasma bomb.
Your orders.
And the ship, enemy ship's gonna run right into the middle of it. Kaboom.
Break them in mind and body!
That is just an iconoclast destroyer. Okay, that shouldn't take too long.
Command me!
You know what? Just to make it on the fun side, lightning strike.
Just show us something to kill!
I don't even know which Chaos Legion. I probably serve as probably a member of the Black Legion here.
Tear them apart!
One chip down. Got more coming.
Come on, me!
Launcher bombers. Oh, he lost his shields. Lost the plasma bomb. This is an idolater.
For the Dark Gods! We are unstoppable!
So far, yeah.
Let the galaxy
burn! There is
burn!
Something. Hellbringer. Oh, it's because he got hit with a disruption bomb.
Just show us something to kill.
Begin reload.
Locking weapons. For the Dark Gods.
Actually, I want you over there.
Engines hot.
You as well. Drop a stasis bomb.
Just show us something to kill!
He's not gonna escape the stasis bomb in time. The stasis field. Kaboom. Which means fire torpedoes.
Ready eternally!
Well, he still got hit by one torpedo.
We've come for your souls! Come on, me!
Launch your bombers, launch the
your plasma orders.
Bomb there. I want you to target the generator. I might actually I'm gonna just remove the bombers with that. Or not. Looks like the plasma bomb doesn't affect the bombers. That's good to know.
Your orders!
That's very good to know, actually.
Adjusting rotation!
Fire torpedoes there.
Command me! Reloading ordnance! Ready eternally!
Hull breach, get repairs. Oh, there's another ship right there, that's why he's taking so much damage.
We've lost an escort ship!
Whoop-de-doo. Demoniac. Oh, that's fun. I lost one of my launch bays.
We've lost one of our line ships!
What the hell just happened?
Tear them apart!
That's wonderful.
Just show us something to kill!
Yeah, I didn't think he'd fall for it again. He might still get hit by it. Yep.
Moving to those coordinates!
Oh, okay, it's because his combustion gauge is low.
Break them in mind and body! For the dark gods! Let the galaxy burn!
Let you take care of that one.
Tear them apart!
I'm guessing the demoniac is what killed my other ship.
Command me!
Launching the stasis bomb. He's gonna be right in the middle of everything.
We've lost an escort ship! We have sighted an enemy ship! Get that damage repaired at once! Ready eternally! Just show us something to kill! Reloading ordnance!
Okay, it must be because he's outside the battlefield zone.
Charging warp engines!
What?
Your orders!
Actually, I should have let him go ahead and do that.
Slaughter them! Set engines to full ahead!
I really should have let him go ahead and escape.
Command me!
I'm not winning this
one.
For
the dark gods!
Just plop the pod right in front of him.
We'll follow your command for now!
I'm gonna have to escape.
Ready eternally!
Actually, no, let's cancel that.
We return to the warp! Break them
okay,
in
good,
mind
their
and shield, body!
Their shields are gone.
Just show us something to kill! We are unstoppable!
Okay, now in theory I could escape with my main ship here. In fact, I probably should. Because all I've got left is my missile pods and my twin link batteries.
Tremble, for chaos comes!
You know what?
Start the rituals!
We're gonna go ahead and escape. Because that ship, I remember. If I can find it. Yeah, this thing's near full health and at level 4. I've got level 5
command
and near
me.
Full health, but they've also got an extra ship. So we're gonna go ahead and get out. Back to the warp. Yeah, defeated is a strong word, considering I got 2 of my line ships out. I kinda wish I'd gotten the 3rd out, but I don't know why it suddenly died. I'll still get 100 renown for that. The Fury of Injustice, why was it blown up? I don't get it. I saw Demoniac successful, and then boom, it was gone. There. We now have the Magnificent Pain in place of that. Alright, folks. Actually, we can go ahead and upgrade the crew here. We're going to go ahead and give you another set of slaves. So you have some lower cooldowns. This thing has missile pods and torpedoes, so... Let's see. I like that idea. Alright, folks. Didn't do so hot on some of these missions, on one of these missions, but we still won a couple of them. What's this? Trader Commodore. Remember, folks, if you enjoy the show, feel free to like or favorite the video, or leave a comment down below if you have something you'd like to say. If you just want to say death to the false emperor, go right ahead. If you think a friend of yours might like any of the four series I've got going right now, please send them my way. That'd be great. I do appreciate that. Also, check out the series tomorrow, or that'll be Friday, where we're still playing in still going for the adventures in Dragon's Reach. That's going quite well, I'd say, so far. Dragon's Reach isn't dead yet. Tune in on Saturday for the next part of To Be a Space Ninja. I did play a little bit off camera there too, although you won't see that just yet. And of course, tune in Sunday for the next episode of Randota. And if you enjoy the show, please feel free to click the subscribe button down below, or there'll be a link at the end of this video. As for that, folks, I have been D. Good night, and good gaming.